Meditation. This is a very vast subject. It has been dealt very well in Bhagavad Gita, 6th chapter, Dhyana Yoga. What is necessary for meditation? Meditation, most important thing is that our mind should be under control. Forget about the senses. Our mind should be under control. Then only we can meditate. This was a big question posed by Arjuna to Lord Krishna. Chanchalam vimanat krishna samadhi balavadrudam. He says, it's very difficult to control the mind. So what is to be done? Very simple words Lord Krishna tells us. Abhyasena sukanchaya vairagyena. By Abhyasa and Vairagya. Abhyasa, there is practice, and Vairagya, detachment of this
passion.
Unless we cultivate detachment and dispassion towards our sense objects, so it is very difficult to do meditation. So one has to practice Abhyasa and Vairagya. So now let us directly get up for meditation. We should have a proper place. Suchamadeshe pratishtapya sthiramasana makaram natyushtitam natinicham chaila shodharam. So now we don't have any kushal grass mat or something like that. So we have to choose a proper place for meditation. It should be very congenial. The place should be clean. Cleanliness is godliness itself. In the dirty place, we cannot meditate. So if you light up an incense stick, we garland the photograph, the picture of our chosen people. That is a very good practice for concentration and meditation. So we have to choose a proper place for meditation. A clean and proper place for meditation. And the place chosen should be same always. Otherwise, our conflict disturbs or it affects our concentration. We have seen in our student days that definitely we occupy a particular place only. The teacher happens change our seat over the Magister. Next day, the parents will approach the principal, telling that you have changed the place of Magister. What? So he is not able to concentrate on his studies. Please put him back in the same place. So also, please choose a place and the same place regularly we sit and meditate. It will help our concentration. Then, place we have chosen. What we require next is an asana. We require something to sit on, and that asana also should be used by you only. Each and every time you meditate, that your asana is fully charged with vibration. So see to it that you have chosen the place and you have chosen your asana for meditation. You can observe this fact when you sit on your asana regularly for meditation. You feel the warmth of it, you feel the vibration of it. So that strictly we have to observe. And then, what should be our next point to consider? Our mind should be brought back, as being referred by Ramakrishna Paramahamsa as gathering of the mustard seeds. So what is necessary for that? The most important thing to bring back our mind to concentrate upon God is chanting mantra, guru mantra, whatsoever it is, whatever you have chosen, that also should be always said. So whenever our mind wanders here and there, when we sit for meditation, we should repeat or chant God's name. We have to observe or we have to witness our own thoughts. So once we observe our thoughts, then we should bring back to our chosen ideal which we are concentrating upon. So before we start doing meditation, we should first pray to our Ishta Devata. We should pray for the well-being of others. We should send our good thoughts to everyone. The sending of the good thoughts, not only to your family members, it should to everyone, including your enemy. Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. The whole world is one family. Think of send your good thoughts to everyone. Not only to human beings, to all the animate and inanimate things. So you are preparing your mind for meditation. Yuktaharam Paniharasya Yukta Cheshtasya Karmasu Yukta Satnavabodasya Yogo Bhavati Dukkha. Overeating is not good, fasting is not good. Too much of play or too much of work is not good, and too less is also not good. Too much of sleep is also not good, and keeping awake is also not good. So, one has to take care of all these things. If just for name's sake you want to meditate, that is okay, simple, as well as there is no matter. We all come at the lotus feet of our Divine Mother, who is there to lead us to the path of the ultimate goal of reality. We have to choose proper time. Time for meditation also, we should maintain the best time to meditate. You have to choose. And as far as possible, you should see that you meditate at the same time. Meditating at the same time also helps in your concentration. As I had mentioned earlier, Mataji had told me if you take my photograph, it will be troublesome for you. I took the photograph and hung it on the wall in my room in Santa Cruz. And then with a big tap, she woke me up in the morning. And I started getting up and and if something comes, that power is going to help us to keep awake, that is most welcome if you happen to take a tap. Okay, Mataji has given a tap to me, and leave it at that. But I didn't leave it. Got that time for more than 40 years. There is a big problem about spirituality also. It is not a simple thing, because the progress cannot be measured. How much you are progressing is not measured. In your business, in your studies, in everything you know, you are putting forth a lot of effort, you are making a lot of money. You had 1 lakh rupees today, and you are made 10 lakhs. You are made 1 crore. You are seeing the progress over there. So also in your studies also, children's work hard. They do all their studies. They do PhD, they do what not, all so many high qualifications they will have. They are seeing the progress. You go to the gym, you work there, work out, and then you are building up your body, getting up your muscles. That doesn't happen in spirituality. 40 years I am in Mataji, I myself see and is any progress. So it is birth after birth. How many births we have to take to get that our goal? Cannot say about that. So we have to strive. Jatasya maranam dhruvam. One who is born, death is certain. So also, birth is also certain. Birth is certain, death is certain, and then rebirth or birth is also certain. It's a cycle. So birth after birth, if you are taking God's name, that you are good. or whatever status you have achieved in your spirituality, that continue further. Lord Krishna tells clearly, it is very difficult. As you advance further, it becomes very difficult for you to get birth in a pious family. Here you are wrong, the subsequent birth has to be in a still more high pious family. That becomes very difficult. So that is possible. One step you take towards spirituality or towards God, that continues birth after birth till you meet the Guru. So also your Guru, when he has taken up your responsibility, he is there with you always. Guru will not leave you. So I was mentioning about the time, sorry I just deviated. So you have to choose proper time convenient to you. So normally it is said that you at Brahma Muhurtam, you do your meditation and in the evening dusk, so before sunrise and before sunset, these are the ideal time for meditation. See, our mind, our emotions, everything depends upon breath. You are mentally disturbed, your breathing is fast. So we have to do pranayama, a little of pranayama you have to do, even if you are not doing that. See that you maintain equipoise or equilibrium of your mind. Then what to do meditation? Before and after, be relaxed. Before you are going to do meditation, be relaxed, keep your mind calm. And so also after your meditation, be relaxed. So chanting of mantra is necessary to focus our attention on the Lord. So what should we choose ourselves? What should we meditate upon? Our meditation should not be, it is not necessary to be confined to any deity as such. Not necessarily we should think of Rama, Krishna or Vishnu or anything like that. In Bhagavad Gita, Lord clearly tells us, meditating, that is saguna pasana, thinking about the divine form or whatever it is, that is easier way to meditate. That is nirguna pasana, having no object of meditation, no form, nothing whatsoever, that is very difficult to practice. So the question arises, we chant some mantras, so is it necessary the mantra which I am chanting and that form only I should meditate? Say I chant Ram Naam, so I can meditate on Lord Shiva. In a family, a person may be, one in the family may be a Christian, one in the family may be a Muslim, one in the family may be a Orthodox Hindu. It doesn't matter. As Mataji tells us, Sabhi dharma Ishwariya dharma hai. All religion leads to the one Almighty, the one Supreme God. So to become a devotee of God is not easy. God tells, I can give you everything, but I cannot give you bhakti, devotion. Why? Lord is dasana dasa. He is servant of the servants and master of the masters. So he doesn't want to become easily your servant. So he takes time to give you bhakti. That is the beauty of it. I will give you everything, but with great difficulty only you can have bhakti. So we can have everything. Having everything also we can do meditation. And we keep doing meditation. So the other qualities follows. Your disinterestedness in everything follows. A person who meditates longer, he loses interest in all other things. By losing interest in all other things, he is advancing in everything. So one has to keep one's mind on the Lord always. So it becomes easy for us when we do meditation regularly. We experience the happiness, the joy, the bliss throughout the day. Once it becomes a habit to you, you will enjoy the whole day. So meditation gives us all these benefits. All those who meditate need not become renouncees or sannyasis. So let us take up the meditation for the peace. We should enjoy that peace throughout the day. That joy which we get in the presence of Mataji or even Guru, that joy we should try to get it in their absence also. Because they are always there with us. Your chosen ideal is always in front of you. You may leave God, but God will not leave you, He will not forsake you. You may forget to call upon Him. He is there to remind you, He is there to bring back to Him, to His lotus feet. when I had the first glimpse of Mataji. Subsequently, I had gone to one of the houses where Bhagwan Shri Sathya Sai Baba's photograph was fully garlanded, and bhajan was in progress. So I also became emotional. I was too deeply thinking of bhakti. Oh Lord, you give me bhakti. You grant me bhakti. Before that, I was not chanting any name of God. I was religious. I was devoted. I belonged to the Orthodox family. But I was not chanting God's name all the time or any time whatsoever. I used to go to the temple and I used to close my eyes and take God's name, that's all. So as I was sitting, praying to Lord, O Lord, you grant me bhakti. Otherwise, I am always like that. I get angry for the things. So I told Lord, if you are not going to grant me bhakti, you make me your humble servant. I am going to break the photos which was worshipped in my new house where Mataji had come and lit the lamp. I am going to break that into pieces. So what happened? The fully garlanded photograph of Shri Sathya Sai Baba slided down, and there was flash of lightning in the Abhaya Hasta of Bhagwan Shri Sathya Sai Baba. From then on, I involuntarily started chanting Om Sai Ram. That name is the gift of God. That name is the blessings of Mother. Okay, with that, I started chanting God's name. Involuntarily, non-stop, without sleep, nothing whatsoever, and keeping the eyes half closed. Like that, not one day, not 2 days, for months. God really granted, let me say, bhakti. So he wanted to save himself. He didn't want that his photograph to be broken into pieces. Then straight away I came to Mataji. Mataji told me, I know everything. Why are you crying so much? That was the end of it. That's Sai Ram. As I mentioned to you just now, I was chanting Om Sai Ram for months, and then it is our natural tendency to forget also. If I happen to stop chanting his name, I used to get the fragrance of that vibhuti. Special fragrance of Baba's vibhuti is there. That I used to get. That to where I was still on the job, I was sitting there. I am not I am doing my work also, but the chanting is involved, the chanting was going on. Just happened to stop, it will be fragrant, beauty, smell of smoke. So again I started chanting. So, when God takes up, He is there with you in and throughout your life. So, what should I tell you? Have I given up anything? No. Vairagya has come to me. I said, I will give up this, I will give up that. Nothing of this. So when God wants you, everything is taken away by Him. So never think of leaving anything. Don't catch hold of it. But you need not leave. So time will come that everything will be taken away by Lord. So that's how, and as I was telling, I came to Mataji, she told me, I know everything, so nothing to worry. So I keep coming to Mataji every day. So that's the beginning of my life with Mataji. In the grace of Mataji, I could be in meditation, as I was telling that you need not sit and meditate, you cannot stand and meditate. I was walking in the busy street, meditating, that is with half closed eyes. I used to walk everywhere in the city of Bombay. That is the glory of God. That is the glory of my great mother and great mother of all of you. So we can meditate in any posture. So that's all I want to tell you. Silence.